first of all, how are you after 12 long hard rounds?
Yeah, all right, mate. Yeah, obviously not marked up much. Yeah, feel all right, mate.
Just talk us through how you felt when obviously going to the cards and waiting for that decision.
I thought I had it. You know, I thought I hit him with the cleaner punches. It was more busier. I thought, you know, I just had him in control. There was times where he obviously come on strong, and I thought the point that it might have looked bad on tally, but you know, I didn't think that was illegal. Get him round. You know, what do you want me to do? Stay there and let him hit me. You know, it was just head down and round. I didn't think I'd get a point taken off. The ref obviously mentioned it a couple of times, but I still didn't think he'd give me more of a solid warning if that's what he was going to do. But even still with that point off, you know, going into the last round, you know, and I won that last round, I thought I had it. I thought I had it, and you know, I think if it had been anywhere else but Germany, I'd have got it. But you know, that's what you're up against when you're coming away, and obviously I'm gutted, but what can you do?
Was that the biggest kind of fear for you, this happening again, you know, ahead of this fight?
But I didn't think it was going to happen. I just didn't think. Yeah, just really just had a gut feeling that I was just going to go in there outworking, which I thought I did. And even though some of the rounds might have been close, which they was, I thought my work rate and my quality of shots would have convinced the judges that, you know, we won the round and won the fight. And yeah, it was, like I said, it just won the fight. I just had a feeling that, you know, we was going to get a first crack at the weapon. Even though some of the rounds were close, I thought I won it. I really do. And, you know, when they said a split decision, I even still thought about it, but when they said 116, 111, I knew we hadn't.
Yeah, what did you make of that? Seems like crazy.
Yeah, party. What can you do? It's the same thing, you know, it's what you're up against when you come to Germany, but I knew that beforehand. And I took that gamble, and again, it's not paid off.
As we said, this happened to you before.
Yeah.
Obviously, Felix Stern, you were kind of less known. It was 4 years ago now.
Yeah.
Martinez, you were always up against it. In a way, does this one feel like the hardest to take?
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
Just because of where you are and the performance you've
been? No, Golovkin was the hardest.
Ah, okay. In terms of the points ones, you know, going to the judges.
Oh, yeah, this was the hardest, yeah. The Golovkin one, I did everything with this, but obviously I took myself away from my family, which I'd never do again. But I trained really hard for this. Yeah. Thought it was at my natural weight, which it was. I thought that was going to be the fights beforehand. The only thing that kept a little bit of doubt in my mind was the fact that I was making middleweight and killing myself to do it. Now at my natural weight, at super middle, I know I'm obviously not the biggest super middle, but you know, I'd rather be my natural weight and be stronger and healthier. So I thought that with me feeling that good at middleweight and not being able to diet, even though I was the smaller one, you know, I thought I was going to do it. You could say really that this is the hard one to take, really, because I really thought I was going to win. I was always confident in them all, but I just thought this was my time, and obviously it wasn't.
Is there a feeling you just think, I can't do this again, I can't have all this work and have this feeling at the end of it?
I can't go away again. It's made me realise that, you know, I thought I was going to win it on the road. It started on the road, I thought it was going to finish on the road and I was going to get one, but it's made me think that I really don't know what to do, but if there was another shot to come up, I just wouldn't take it on the road. Can't keep doing it, mate. I can't keep doing it to myself, to my family, to Oliver, you know. There's nothing you can do, do you know what I mean? I thought if it had been anywhere in Germany, like I said, I thought I got it. But, you know, I've not, and that's the way it is. But it's like when obviously I'm seeing my wife rings her and she's crying, and, you know, I'm just in the changing room, just phoning a little lad and a little girl, and they're crying, and, you know, that's what does me.
Yeah.
I know, seeing Oliver, we just thought that we had it. And, you know, that's what does me more than anything. I don't know how long I can keep doing it.
Mm. But on the kind of bright side, with that in mind, that at home, back at home, there's a lot. It's such a good division at home.
Oh, there's going to be
made big fights and stuff back, and you might never have to leave England again.
Well, yeah, that'd be great. that'd be great, but it's just my luck that'll never happen. Mm. I hope it does, but yeah, we'll just wait and see what's happening now. We're going to have a good break, a nice break. Spend some time with family because I've been away with them. Been away from them for the past couple of weeks. And yeah, just have a good rest and see where we go from here.
Are you going away on holiday, isn't it?
Yeah, going away. Yeah, I've got going away twice in December. So
Christmas at home then?
Back Christmas Eve. Christmas at home and then away 30th of December. So gonna have a nice time over Christmas. And yeah, just weigh up my options.
Mm. Retirement not an option at the moment.
In fact, I really don't know what I'm going to do, I'll be honest with you.
Mm. I suppose emotions are kind of running.
Yeah.
It's not the time to make
it. No, I'm obviously a bit gutted.
Mm.
I don't want to retire. I feel like I'm only just getting into my prime, but I don't know what I can do. Mm. You know, I just need a bit of luck and a world title shot at home.
He obviously granted Paul Smith that immediate rematch, but Andy said that he can't really see a rematch happening. What would you?
No,
could you see that down the line? Do you think he'd want to fight you again anyway?
No, but if it was going to be in Germany. And like I said, I don't know if I'd come again because I can't keep facing it. But yeah, I mean, what did you say then?
Do you think that the rematch is possible? Could you see it?
No.
You can't see that down the pipeline?
No, definitely not. And like I said,
it's been a long day.
It'd be over there if it was. So yeah, and he's got a fight in mandatory anyway, that remains, I believe. So, yeah.
Do you think it was kind of insinuated there by Barry and the presser that he won't come out of Germany? Do you think it does kind of take the legacy a bit for him? Because he is a dominant champion, he has been a great champion, yeah. But he never wants to leave Germany.
No,
and when he does, he's got beaten.
Yeah, so, I think it does, you know, it's pretty much with Stern, really. You know, I think you get more credit for going away and fighting, in other people's territory, but as I know firsthand, it don't work out for you, so, you can't blame him, really, if you think of it, really, but even though he is getting gifted decisions, why leave Germany if you don't have to? But having said that, it does damage his reputation a little bit, in my honest opinion.
Just finally, thanks very much for your time, but just a message for those fans there.
Yeah, we always are, coming out there, seeing them all there, it sometimes it makes me think, why they all support me, why they all follow me, I feel really lucky. So yeah, just a massive thank you to all the supporters who come over, and I'll keep you posted on what's going to happen next, but I think the show must go on, I'll be honest with you, just a massive thank you, and I look forward to the next one.
Right, no, thanks very much.
Cheers, mate.
Really appreciate that.